I think in this project, what we are trying to achieve is basically the visibility of our women in Zambia, those that are serving in parliament and those that are serving in the councils. I think we realize as Zambian National Women's Lobby that mostly our women in Zambia, their stories are untold. They go untold. So we realized we needed to have these women bring to the attention of the people of Zambia what it is that they do. We wanted to bring it to the fore. We wanted the people of Zambia to see that our women actually are working.
I feel the most beautiful thing about being a woman is the fact that we were made strong. We as women were built with a special strength. We have more emotion, and that helps us also in certain decisions that we make. I hear a lot of people say women should not be in politics, for example. You know, they're not strong enough. Who told you that? You know, we are able, and there is actual examples of women who've been able to lead countries and do fantastic work because we do have our special qualities that make us women.
As a young housewife, my husband was in the Ministry of Education and we were posted to the Copper Belt. I think that's where I was introduced to the Young Women's Christian Association. This was just before independence. The Young Women's Christian Association was the first organization that was responding to the needs of women. But then, around the year 2000, the women of Zambia realized that if we talk on the sidelines and not get involved in actual politics, it may be just an exercise in futility. So a number of women were encouraged to enter politics with the blessing of the women's movement. And that's how they told me that you are head of the NGOCC, the Non-Governmental Coordinating Committee at that time, as it was called, you should live by example. So I threw myself into politics. Luckily, I was elected at the first attempt. And quite a number of women stood in the elections of 2001, but unfortunately, not many made it.
Parliament has 15% women, and if you go down to the local government, we have about 6% women representation, and that is really far from what our aspirations and desires are. When women are left out completely, as it has been the case so far, you are actually putting away the brains that would have contributed. Because it's not a rule that the only people that have the brains to do it are men. There are some brilliant women who, if given an opportunity, will do a much better job than the men. So we cannot continue sidelining one gender.
I got into politics because of the community. They kept on coming to me, asking me. But then I said, oh, wow, the community must have seen something in me. Then at the end of the day, I actually agreed. The first thing I told them, I said, you identified me because I'm a hard worker. I equally want you to be like me. The people should not believe to say the government should do everything for them. They've also got a part to play. So whenever there's a project, I make sure the community is involved because they are the ones who come with those projects. And I've told them to say, I cannot work alone. We have to actually work together. Now, there are times when you sideline. Maybe you sideline the men or you sideline the women. I haven't done that in my ward. I'm the firstborn in the family, and I was followed by boys only. So whenever my parents wanted to give assignments to the boys, they included me. So that made me actually believe to say, whatever a man can do, I can equally do. is something which they have accepted to say we are partners in any development we are actually trying to achieve in our world. We cannot do it as women alone, or they cannot do it as men alone. So we need each other. And this is what I've actually instilled in my community, to say we need each other, we are partners in any development which we need in our community. And you see, even the community, I thought the time when they identified me, they were going to say, no, why are you actually talking of a woman to stand as a counselor? It wasn't like that. They knew I was a woman, but they approached me.
So we cannot continue sidelining one gender and just say this will be replaced by another man. It doesn't work like that. But because we've been a patriarchal society, these women are not given an opportunity. But what is also true is that the few women that have been given an opportunity, they have delivered.
You're welcome.
Thank you for having us,
and Honorable. What can so I grateful. Do for you?
A lot, actually.
I'm here every Friday afternoon. This is a day that is given to our electorates to come and interact with me. Most of them, like this, the teachers and others, nurses, they come in because of maybe they have a problem with the clinic or the school, and then we need to help them. And sometimes we get into our personal money, because some cases, really, you just have to put up a human face to it. Just when you have a bit, you share with them.
A number of 600 children from just January. I think congratulations, you must have.
When people have come, we don't turn anybody back. We make sure that everybody is seen, nobody goes back without being seen.
If you feel like if you have any concerns, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us, because this is why we are here. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We have to relate to the people. We have to interact with the people, because the people want you to listen to them, to accept their concerns, to carry these concerns to Parliament.
When we came into Mandevu, Mandevu was not what it is today. I have lobbied for so many roads for them. Tarmacs have been put. We've built clinics. We have done police posts. We needed about 32 bridges, and I think I've done 12 out of 32 using the CDF.
So you have to be a mother to your constituency and be in touch with your constituency throughout your term of office. That way the people will feel that you are with them, you truly represent them, you represent their interests.
When you talk about society and what obtains in society, you realize that it requires men and women to make contributions or to see where the national cake is being shared, for them to agree on who takes what and who takes this. Most of the things that we go through, especially in Zambia, Zambia is a third world country, most of the things that we go through require a lot of contributions from the women. So we need a society that is going to have balanced decisions when they look at what is on the table, when they begin to share that the women, the men together agree on what is going to develop the nation. A developing country needs a lot of effort. We need consensus. We need to agree, the men and women, to see how we take our country forward.
Yeah, so when I'm singing about women, I basically just try to get everybody to understand and appreciate the rights of women. I think that culturally, we have been made to believe that women are less able to make good and important decisions because of the environment in which we have lived, where our fathers always told us that men were more powerful in everything, men were more intelligent. And so because it's been like that, it's very unfortunate, and I believe that this is one of the reasons that people like myself have now come out to try by all means to make the nation realize that the situation can actually change, and I pray that things should change. Well, men can simply get involved by, first of all, using the different platforms that they have. Anywhere you are, whether in the workplace, in the family, you should just learn to appreciate a woman as a partner in development. We just need to realize that a woman is equally important and just give her the same opportunity that you have without thinking that you should always be in the lead and then the woman should always come later. I think gone are the days when we used to look at things that way. This time around, we are all equal and we can decide at any time that the woman is going to start and then the man will follow. Or the other way around, it should just flow, you know.
Councillor Zalomis, I'm the area councillor for Sima Cheche Ward, which is in Choma Central constituency. When I stood in 2011 as the area councillor for Sima Cheche, I was not alone. We were five. I was the only woman. But because of my courage and the vision which I had for the ward, I pulled through the whole four men. I beat them up. I'm still a woman. I didn't become a man. I'm a woman. So when a man stands up to talk, you stand up as a woman to talk as well. Because you're just a human being like him. The only difference is you put on a dress, a man puts on a trousers. Otherwise, we're the same. We're the same ways of doing things, if not better than men, we women. Because when we aim at something, that thing happens.
Something that we hope as the National Council will grow into something bigger.
Being a woman in leadership, for me, I think the most important thing about being a woman in leadership is inspiring other women to be leaders.
And we thank you from the
there are so many stories of women in leadership because we have had women leading. It's not a new thing. When you think about it, in this country, the majority of the bigger tribes that came here, the Lozi, you know, the Way, the Sala, they were led here by women leaders, and the Tongas had a woman leader who was much more respected than anybody else. When the colonials came, they recognized so much more of the men, the male chiefs, for example. When in some instances the actual power was with the female chief, but because they came from a patriarchal Victorian England or whatever, the whole thing was turned upside down. Today we have many, many male chiefs and much less in terms of female chiefs, but before it was the other way. You know, we're fighting again for things we had before. Women in leadership is not a new thing. It has always been there, so let's just embrace it and get on with it, because it's part of our heritage.
My goals are simple, which I want to attain in my lifetime, like to see a happy community, my community, Sima Cheche Ward. I want them to have clean water, good roads, clinics, police posts, good schools. I don't do things alone. I need to involve the community. You're discussing developmental issues. How do we go about this development? What do we do from here? Where do we go from here? As a community leader, as a councillor, you don't have to be a boss. No. You just give ideas how things are supposed to be done. When they talk to me, I listen. Whatever they ask me to do, I go back to the council and ask for that, and I make sure I get what I ask for.
So this year's Women's Day was a day for celebration of who women are and what they have contributed so far. And if you give an even more space, what they can contribute.
Zambia now has a constitution that is speaking to gender equality and the rights of women. this is time when women, in celebrating today, should reflect and say, how do we take advantage of the situation that is before us? That is what we should be doing. And let me take this opportunity to call on all the women across Zambia that time is now. There will be no other time for us to participate.
What we should be saying to Zambia, we need our space in the governance of this country because this is what we've been able to achieve. And why we have to continue reminding the President of the Republic of Zambia that we need to be part of decision making and part of the drivers of the economy of this country. And I think it was very clear, even as the President went around the stands, he was amazed, even at the thought process of women. By 2030 is a desire by this government to ensure that the presence of women, whether it's in employment or what, is 50% men, 50% women by 2030.
Women, they are focusing on the actual needs of society. They are going out there. And they are not going to go there and just campaign. They are going there to see how children are managing. Is there immunization of these young ones? What about these that have HIV AIDS? Are they being properly supported? What about the hungry, the poor, the sick? Are they being looked after properly? I don't know when they become leaders whether they can still do those things, but. To me, the women in politics can play a very, very big role because maybe even poverty can be reduced because their caring is different from our male colleagues.
I could see the people, the way people are living in the community. It doesn't really please me. This compound from Kabanana used to walk a long distance to go to another health center, which is not good for a pregnant woman, a very sick person. They are poor people. They've got no vehicles. That clinic, when I came into office in 2011, I found it was just four walls with iron sheets. You couldn't call it a clinic. I went to the council. I applied for CDF, I was funded. The materials which I received is for the completion of the clinic. It was not functional, but now they're using it. There are a lot of orphans in my community. That's the reason why I came up with an idea of forming clubs, so that we can find something to do to raise money to help these children going to school. I went to lobby from YDO. For machinery. I was given two knitting machines and two sewing machines. So they're making use of those machines to make uniforms, school jerseys. It helps them to feed their homes, their families, taking the children to school, and also sponsor those same orphans within their community. These clubs are being run by married women and widows. I think they need a lot of support. They've got no support. That's the reason why I thought of coming up with the clubs, so so that at least they'll be able, out of the income they make from there, they'll be able to help themselves. If more women are empowered in the community, we're going to have a better community, because a lot of women will be independent. I wanted every woman to be comfortable, which is not easy. Yeah. It's quite a big challenge. A woman needs help from somewhere.
So what women normally do, even despite the fact that they've been marginalized, they have a way of finding their space. So they know they've been marginalized in professional jobs, so they've found their space in income generation to be able to earn money.
My achievements in my ward actually are quite a chain of them. But the first one which I can actually talk about is the mindset which I've actually brought in the community, where I can say I've been their mentor. There are certain projects which are actually directed to the women to make sure these women can be able to stand on their own. This beekeeping project is actually being handled by women. We are able to harvest honey in a conducive manner and package it nicely for customers to come and buy. When that project came in, they were a bit skeptical because they thought that project had come there for men only. You see, sometimes women fear reading and training, but I told them to say their training will be given to you. They're not just going to say, no, you go into this when you have no idea, no. They've done a lot of training, and this is why they're even able to do the banking. When you form up a club, like we have formed a club, we actually told them to say, can you choose your own executive, which they have done. That is part of leadership, because they are going to choose a chairperson, a treasurer, a secretary, out of the same. So these women have actually benefited from that, and now they are able to do things on their own. They do come to town when they sell the honey to do the banking on their own. Yeah. I know the harvest is done twice in a year, but during that period when they are waiting for that, we do have other projects which they carry on. We have the goat keeping, which they are doing, and they also have their own gardens. So we find that the little money they get, they are able to multiply it in so many different ways.
So njikala fene kanava ana. Ndalima matava, kandolo, imbalala, naliteka n'engombe. Mu bulime bwandi, ndakwanisha okusambirisha abaana b'esukulu. I've got two, abali ku college. Ndabasambisha, ndabalipirira. Kiretontonkanya okuupa, oluba nandibalanda kuli okuupa, nebo fino fine. Bantu ndayibombera n'emwine. Ndasolva ma problem nemu ino kupitira mu bulimi bwandi ebo nchita.
You see, we have women who are very good at running gardens. They are able to produce, they are producers, but they cannot go and sell. But at the same time, we have women who are good at selling. So what usually happens is that these women who are producers get in touch with those women who are selling at the markets. They do the harvesting and they take to the market to go and sell to the public. So they complement each other. This other person is able to produce and this other person is able to order and sell to the community. So I think that means a lot for me, and that is something which is making me proud to say a woman is able to achieve something in my ward.
So if in agriculture, for example, the biggest growers of food are not the men, it's the women. They found their niche there, and they are producers of food. And if you go to homes, where the women are active. Even all this talk about, you know, things are so hard in Zambia, our economy is difficult. Where there are women that are participating, their families are doing well. And I think we should take advantage of this positive energy that women have and take it to economic development.
You look at the women that our presidents have had. We had Mrs. Vera Chiruba that time, and her, I don't know whether it was Hope Foundation. We had Mrs. Manawasa with her Manawasa Initiative. We had Dr. Christine Kaseba with also her programs. And currently we have the current First Lady, Mrs. Lungu, who is also very busy going around, you know, communities and helping them. So you find that women, to me, those women should have actually been even presidents or vice presidents, because the way they work, they are focusing on the actual needs of society.
It has taken us more than 50 years to challenge the subordination of women in all aspects of life. But there have been some changes, I must admit. If there were no changes, I would not be in this position today. The issues of girls dropping out of school is not a new phenomenon, but now there's more impetus to stop the scourge, because we realize that one of the reasons why women are being conditioned to the situation they are in today is sometimes because of lack of education. If these girls had adequate education, had gained the skill, and they are in employment, they can be independent. They can be on their own.
Every single day I'm in this office, I'm exposed to the suffering of the Zambian people, especially women, young girls, and children. And one of the biggest issues, I think, for which has emerged in this country is the whole issue of gender-based violence. Within this gender-based violence are all the issues like child marriage. And when you actually take out child marriage and interrogate it and unpack it, then you see all the linkages with everything else, like development, labor issues, and so on.
We have actually gone in to sensitize the community to say, you rip off more when a girl child is married at the rightful time.
First of all, we approach homes where people come from, especially where young girls are. We go there to sensitize, telling them the dangers that are there.
Shako daba kunta suppose ku school so fashiona sa limbichu po at least go shape so now problem doing to 2016 January ne wari fani ne oteba ma.
It's something which I can describe to say it is alarming. So we have actually teamed up with the Zambia Police, One Stop Center, and social welfare.
Ina prova jibi baisa isakono, na kuisa nsambilishi. Na sasanga mwati, cha ama wana mandifume uvunasa ufunya kuchupa kulia, oba ike good school. Inecho fapa wana nifuana wandibaka sambilile. Ukuchira, ukupua waiche waiche. Fapaka sambilile, waka sangemo, ubusu wa mkusambilila.
I appreciate to have a counselor like Dorothy Mambwe, because she is more like a breath of fresh air to us in this area. Yeah, and she's a role model to all the people around. She got involved into this program. She was the one who came up with this program maybe 2-3 years ago. Mm-hmm. And most girls, I think, have returned back to their mothers, and they are willing to go back to school. Yeah. So Dorothy is a great help to us, the community, and the whole entire country in Bosch. Yeah.
My wish for my daughter Asante is that she can get all the opportunity that she's ever dreamt of. And I want her to be able to achieve her dreams, for her to be able to go and conquer the world. I wish for a time where when she decides she wants to do something as crazy as working for NASA or something and wants to go to the moon, that I'll be able to give her the opportunity to do that without any limitations. I am at a place where, honestly, I'm trying to find the right way of doing it, but I really, really have this heavy burden on my heart which says, you need to step up and help your country. I'm hoping there are more young women out there who are thinking about it and who are contemplating it. If they are, I want to meet them. So yeah, you never know. One day, if you hear I'm in politics, don't be shocked.
If we have women that have the intelligence, they have the zeal to get into politics, then Zambia National Women's Lobby will build their capacity. That's what we begin with. And then we go into their constituencies to sensitize the masses, to make them understand why it is important for them to have the women in the councils, to have the women in parliament, and basically to just have the women even at community leadership level.
You know, I think someone very wise said, whatever is happening to your country is happening to you. And if whatever is happening in your country is happening to you, then you better have a say in what is happening in your country, because it will be happening to you. So for me, getting involved in some way in the destiny of your country, whether it's by voting or whether it be decision making or whatever, because all of us are part of this country, then I think then we get involved. We must be involved.
I would love these women to actually aspire to these offices. They should not look at the finances. We have Zambia National Women's Lobby. That's why it is there for us. I got support from them, and I got support from the community. It's not always about money, no. Sometimes it's the wisdom you get from the people, and you get inspired, and you end up winning your elections. Women are performers, and they have actually performed. Wherever they have stepped, they have performed. I am an example. Thank you.
Da-da-da.